And when we have Jesus Christ as our Savior, that is one thing that we can definitely without a doubt say. That it is well with our soul. And there may be seasons when we get tired and tough and weary, or worn and weary. But I'm so thankful to know that it is still well with my soul.
Amen.
You know, this nation, when they're looking for hope, they're looking for it in all the wrong places. And if anything, the church should have realized over this past year, had the time to spend time in prayer. Because we do not wrestle against flesh and blood. And our battleground is in our prayer ground. And I look back over it and I'm like, you know, I'm not sure I prayed enough. I think almost all of us can say, I'm not sure I prayed enough. You know, we can, whether you were for, whether you were a Democrat or Republican or for a Trump or for a Biden, or it didn't matter. Did we pray and seek after his face? Lord, put the ruler, put the leaders there in which can turn to you. Did we pray? Did we fight on that battleground as Pastor was just talking about? During this season, we've got to do one thing, and that's what this next chorus, the song's going to go right into, is did we turn our eyes on Jesus? Did we turn our eyes on the focus of which Christ and the example in which he set? And I look at it and I'm like, I'm still striving to do exactly that. I will fail. And, you know, being up in front of a microphone, it's just amplified now because of social media. So when you mess up, you mess up big. But I can say that I'll do my best. But I'm going to keep my eye on Jesus. And may I follow after him.
Turn your eyes upon Jesus. Look full in his wonderful face, and the things of earth will grow strangely dim in the light his glory and turn your eyes upon Jesus. Look full in his wonderful face, and the things of earth will grow strangely dim in the light of his glory and
turn our eyes on him, right? You know, I love them old hymns, and I know from being here in the past that y'all enjoy them too, and I love because y'all can sing right along with me, because if anything, you can pick up on them pretty quickly, because most of them, repeat in the chorus and everything like that. But I love that hymn medley that I've sang here before. Just a reminder of that old-time religion, when we were excited about what God had done for us through his son. We had that passion, that drive. May we do that, even today, even when it's tough and everything like that. We can put a smile on our face because Jesus is our Savior. I love that. If we could just get back to our focus on Him. Focus on that example in which He set when He was here on this earth. So I know we've been quiet for a little bit, and everybody's, you know, you either listen to Pastor, or now you got to put up with me with that microphone. But, you know, we can maybe snap our fingers on this next one or pat our lap or something. But, you know, I'm going to take probably some requests here in a few moments. You know, if I've got it, I'll do my best to sing it. But we're here to worship God. You know, I can sing. Yeah, pastor can preach. But we're here to worship God. And what better place to do it today? I mean, you know, we're here outside in the beauty of His creation. You've got mountain ranges on the left, my right, and right. You look at the trees. To think what it took, and He just spoke it into life. We just look at it as there's some firewood. We're going camping. But when you sit and you think, you start looking around. You don't get to do this in a church building. Sit and you just hear some birds. Every once in a while you might get zapped with one. There's a nest up there, but we're out here saying, God, we love You. We praise You. Stir something in us.
Amen.
Give me that old-time religion, give me that old-time religion, give me that old-time religion, it's good enough on me. Give me that old-time religion, give me that old-time religion, give me that old-time religion, it's good enough on me. Well, I heard an old, old story, how a Savior came from glory. How He gave His life on Calvary to save a wretch like me. I heard about His groaning, of His precious blood atoning. Then I repented of my sins, I won the victory. Oh, victory! My Savior forever. He sought me and He bought me with His redeeming blood. He loved me ere I knew Him, and all my love is to Him. He plunged me to victory beneath the cleansing flood. Won't sing it. Oh, victory in Jesus, my Savior forever. He sought me and He bought me with His redeeming blood. He loved me ere I knew Him, and all my love is due Him. He plunged me to victory beneath the cleansing flood. What a fellowship, what a joy tonight, leaning on the everlasting arms. What a blessedness, what a peace is mine, leaning on the everlasting arms. I'm leaning, yes, I'm leaning. Safe and secure from all alarms, leaning as I'm leaning. I'm leaning on the everlasting arms. religion, give me that old time religion, give me that old time religion, it's good enough for me. Give me that old time religion, give me that old time religion, give me that old time religion, it's good enough for me.
It's good enough for me.
Amen.
You know, that's the amazing part. Out of everything that changes in this world, God remains the same.
Amen.
So, I know we might call it old-time religion, but it's still the same as it was then. It is as it is today. So that's why we come and we fellowship together. We come together to reignite, to refresh, to recharge. You don't have, you know, if people are, I talk to a lot of people, and they'll, oh, I don't need to go to church. No, you don't need to go to a building. No, you don't have to go to Wednesday Bible study. No, you don't have to get up early and come to Sunday school on Sunday. But how are you getting refreshed? Because we can fellowship with God every day, every moment, every hour. And I'm thankful that God didn't cut that off. He could have been a dictator. He's God. I mean, he created. He could have just said, well, I want a bunch of people that bow down to me, and here it is. But he wanted a relationship. He wanted us to want him. I mean, you think about that. That's it. Like, that's even in our blood. We want to feel needed. And we all have gifts. I sing, Pastor preaches. We all have gifts. Some may think that, oh, well, it's so small. But what, and I had this conversation with someone, what if maybe one of the only purposes that you had was to sit and listen? Some people just need an ear to listen. And you're sitting there listening, and you just tell them, you know what? Jesus loves you. And that sparks that moment where you get to share what Christ coming into their life could be. Everybody was created for something great. As we just put our focus on God and say, all right, use me. And I'm thankful for that. I'm blessed to be able to do that. And, you know, I realize more and more how much I need him every day. Especially, you know, I've got two little boys. And as I was telling Pastor, it'll be public knowledge tomorrow, so it'll be all right. But, you know, I've got a third one on the way. And I'm going to need the Lord, especially if it's another boy. I got two, and I'm sitting there going, I know you love me, but are you just torturing me? And they act just like me. And so I'm sure I'm getting some payback. Everybody says it, you know. You'll hear it. So for the two youngins, this is for you. Everything that you do to your parents, you will be, you know, you'll hear in the Bible, you hear about, you know, tenfold and all of that. For some reason, it keeps following true for all of that, that you all give them tough times. Yeah, it comes back. I'm getting that now. I'm getting a dose of that now. But, you know, but I'm blessed.
Oh, yeah.
For that. And he's not going to give us something that we can't handle. Now, we may feel like that we can't handle it. There will be seasons where we need to, you know, we're going to grow. And growing, there's growing pains. But I love that chorus of just singing, I need thee. Lord, I need thee. Need thee, oh,
that my Savior, I come to thee.
Come on, sing it with me.
I need thee, Lord, I need thee. My Savior, I come to thee.
God sent His Son.
They called Him Jesus. He came to love, heal, and forgive. He lived and died to buy my pardon. And then prove my Savior lives, because He lives, I can face tomorrow, because He lives, all fear is gone. Because I know He holds my future, and a life is worth the living just because He lives.
How sweet to hold
a newborn baby and feel the pride and joy He brings, but greater still is that call assurance this child can face a certain place, because He lives. And then one day I'm gonna cross that river. I'll find life's but then as death gives way to victory, I'll see the light, glory, and I'll know He reigns, because He lives, I can face because He lives. All fear is gone, because I know, yes, I know He holds my future, and a life is worth the living just because He lives. Yes, life the living just because He lives.
Amen. Because He lives. Pastor gets it. When you can just start getting that chuckle, and you're reminded that, yeah, He lives. And because He lives, we have hope. We have a future. I just sit and, you know, I've been very fortunate. It seems like over the past little bit, of course, things are a little more outside now, which I think is even better. I don't know if you hear sometimes when I talk, but it just echoes off the mountains.
Yeah.
And it ain't even cranked up, trust me. I should have just turned the speakers around and just cranked it up, and just it would have been enough then for under here. But just here in the backside of them. But over the past, even just this past week, not only today, but just seeing the being able to sing outside and seeing the beauty of mountains and stuff like that, and just really admiring what God has blessed us with. And I was down in that other Virginia state. They let me out of West Virginia into Virginia, and you know, I slipped over the border is what it was, I guess. But I was down there and singing at a fair, and it was right in the smack dab of, I was pointing right into a mountain, and but just the view and the beauty of it was awesome. And folks just came out at a county fair just to praise Jesus, and that's what we did for 2 hours. And it was awesome. Just time to fellowship, to praise the Lord. So, you know, I mentioned that I would take requests. I mentioned to you, and, you know, maybe be thinking about something, and I don't know if you've thought about anything yet, but we're in that, in almost a casual sitting around a campfire, you know, kind of setting. But you know, it doesn't always have to be professional.
You want to do Chainbreaker?
I can do Chainbreaker. I will. Because that's what He is.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. You know, it's amazing that someone writes a song about breaking a chain and people go crazy over it. And, you know, this one has been one of those songs that's hit all genres. You know, it actually was released in a, you know, what society is calling contemporary, but it's went through Southern gospel, country gospel. But the message is so simple that people are like, that's it. And that's, you know, when you have a conversation with someone about Christ, it's like, but yeah, it's that simple. We complicate it. Well, we put religion in it and complicated it. And when we just share Christ and the way that He is made so that we can be with the Father, you know, we're never alone through the Holy Spirit, and I'm thankful that God breaks those chains of bondage in our lives. So I'm going to sing that song, and then I'll ask everybody else, if you got someone, you just off it right out, but we'll sing that one.
If you've been walking the same old road for miles and miles, if you've been hearing the same old voice tell the same old lies, if you've been trying to fill the same old holes inside, there's a better life. There's a better life. If you got faith, He's a pain taker. If you feel lost, He's a way maker. And if you need freedom or saving, He's a prison-shaking Savior. If you got chains, He's a chain breaker.
Yeah.
We've all searched for the light of day in the dead of night. We've all found ourselves worn out from the same old fights. And we've all run to things we know just ain't right. But there's a better light. There's a better light. If you got faith, he's a pain taker. If you feel lost, now he's a way maker. And if you need freedom or saving, he's a prison shaking savior. If you got chains, he's a chain breaker. If you believe it, if you've received it, if you can feel it, somebody testify. If you believe it, if you've received it, if you can feel it, somebody testify, testify. If you believe it, if you've received it, if you can feel it, somebody testify. If you got pain, he's a pain taker. If you feel lost, he's a way maker. And if you need freedom or saving, he's a prison shaking savior. If you got chains, he's a chain breaker. He's a chain breaker.
Yes, amen. You better believe it.
Many, many chains have been broken.
I think we've all been down that road.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Anybody else?
Do you know my Savior Shadow, what Blake Shelton is?
I don't. I picked that up, but I have not gotten it down.
Okay.
But I have my laptop with me.
This song got me through my husband in the hospital because he got COVID back in, that was April, right? April, yes. He got COVID and he ended up on a ventilator for 14 days. And then the doctor called me after the 14 days and he told me there's nothing else we can do. Put your son on a speakerphone because I need to tell him. He's live here, say no, he's in Florida. And he said, just send him up here because you're gonna need him on the next few days. You can start preparing whatever you guys need to prepare. There's nothing else we can do for him. And then I call Jenny, and then I call, they're always with me. So, and then I say, there's nothing else you guys can do? He say, no. And I ask him again, I say, absolutely nothing you can do? And he say, no, there's nothing else we can do. And then after a few minutes, he just said to me, we can try to prone him again, but and then we're gonna have to multiply the sedation for him. And at that point, nothing else you can do, so just give the sedation. So, and then they tried the sedation on that night, and his body rejected. So they could not completely paralyze him. And next day was on Thursday, he called me and he said, I'm not knowing what's going on. His body don't take anything that we tried to do with him. There is absolutely nothing we can do. We need a miracle. I said, and I believe in one. So we good. And I said, you're going to see a miracle soon. And that was on Thursday. He told me the 18th. On Thursday, nothing that they try work. And on Saturday, I was standing at the hospital. I could only see him through the glass. And he came behind my back and he said, I do not know what you're doing, but whatever you're doing, you keep on doing because I'm about to take your husband out of the ventilator. And
that's right.
And I just look at him and I say, you're going to do what? Is that safe? He said, it is safe. It's safer for me to take him out than keep him on. Because I think when he's out of there, he will do better. So, And I told him, that's a miracle. He said, that's absolutely a miracle. Whatever you're doing, you keep on doing. And I remember right in there, I called Jenny on the phone and I said, they're going to remove him out of the ventilator. And she just said, you just knee down where you are. I don't care if you're in the middle of the hallway. Just knee down there because he's going to get out of that ventilator without gasping, without anything. And he was. And next day, they took him out of isolation. And the dog, a week after, they released him out of the hospital and they say he's going to spend a period of six months on oxygen at home and taking a lot of medication for his lungs. 30 days after he was home, he has no medication for his lungs. He's not on the oxygen of any type and no side effects, no nothing from COVID. He's
praise the Lord.
Working. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. And that's what we, you know, when we talk about the word of our testimony, to encourage people, to uplift them and hear what God can do.
Yes.
Because as what you were saying, as what Pastor was reading this morning, it's not the flesh and blood.
Nope.
But it's that battleground of prayer. And it's not easy sometimes. And that is just one of those awesome times where you can just say, God really showed up right there.
Is the problem, no, it's not a problem. It's just like, there is one more thing we can do. We can prone him. And God say, no, now is my time. This is not going to work. I'm going to do without you guys doing your last resort. Yeah. Now it's just me. I will move away because it's just me.
Right.
And the doctor was from India. So I'm not so sure if he believed or not. And he said, whatever you're doing, you keep on doing it because it's working. And I said, I'm praying.
Yeah.
And I'm worship. That's what I'm doing. I'm worshiping him because that's the giant. The giant is gonna fall as I raise my hallelujah to it.
Yeah.
So
that's it. Amen. Well, this will just be a who knows what happens, but I'm getting one song out of all your requests. I may butcher it, and I think they're recording it, so it's gonna be even worse, right? But
No,
well, oh, good. Judy edits. Good deal. Judy, and we are praying for you that everything, you just keep recouping and everything like that. And
thank you.
We look forward to hearing great reports. And but you can edit all my mess ups out in the 20 minutes that it took me to find. That's just one song. But I'm getting one song. Whether or not I can figure out the timing, I haven't worked on this thing in months. So, well, we're going to get it, because that's at least one song. And I'm hoping this is not the demo, but the actual accompaniment. Let's see. I don't want to blast y'all out. Let's see what happens. I'm standing in my Savior's shadow. He is watching over me. I feel the rain, I hear the thunder as He cries for me. I'm standing in my Savior's shadow. Grace will lead to where I'm free. I take His hand, we walk together, His light shines on me. Though the devil tried to take me, my sweet Jesus won't forsake me. When I'm in my Savior's shadow, where I'm supposed to be. Standing in my Savior's shadow, following His footsteps there. Every mountain, every ocean, He's my every prayer. Though the devil tried to break me, my sweet Jesus won't forsake me. When I'm in my sin. I know I didn't have any of your other ones, so I'll sing maybe. You want one more?
It's up to you.
I'm good. We're just kind of kicking back like a family back porch outing. So,
definitely.
I mean, I've been here enough. I might as well say, part of the family.
Amen. Yeah. Yes.
That's one of the great things of, getting to go back to places. You see folks and you build relationships, and I'm thankful for that. Not everybody gets to do that all over the place. I meet folks all the time, and I won't remember your name, I guarantee it. But more than likely, I remember faces, and sometimes if you see me out at the mall or something, give me a cue as to where I'm looking. But it's awesome to get to hear people's story and where they've been, what they've been through, and maybe transformations. You never know the impact that you can have on someone's life. And I love to share moments that, and I'm thankful for, I'll share this story. I just had it was just the other day, and I was at a church, and we passed passing some friends of mine, and she said, "I need to tell you something." And I'm like, sometimes you never know what that means. her and her husband stand there, her son, and she said, "You don't know this." And I said, "Well, okay, there's a lot of stuff I don't know, but maybe this is a moment that I don't really want to know." And she said, "Do you remember back?" And I'd asked her about being in the choir. We were having an Easter choir. It was a special. I wasn't asking her to join for the every Sunday choir, but I said, "Hey, we have a special choir coming up. Why don't you join in?" And she said, "You kept after me." I said, "Well, I was just having some fun with it, you got to come join the choir." You laugh with it, but hey, if someone comes and is a part of something that's great and you use one of your talents and stuff like that. And she said, "You kept after me, and I finally said yes." And she said, it ended up transforming our family. We started getting involved. Before that, we came Sunday morning and we went home. I don't tell you that to say, "Oh, look, I did something great," and I had no idea. I was honestly just picking. I like to pick a lot. And but God can use even the littlest things that you think are absolutely nothing, such as inviting someone to sing in a choir, to help transform a family, to start getting involved more and diving in more and coming together more and uniting more, all because he said, "You want to be in the choir?" That goes to show that what we perceive sometimes is so small, so infinite, so just minute of even just sitting outside. How do we know there's not somebody listening that's carrying through these mountains? We don't know. So may we always be willing to Just be who God created us to be. Joke, laugh, smile. You could be like one of my coworkers. She just likes to cry. Some people just are able to do that, you know. But we can never underestimate what God can take with what we think is nothing and multiply it in great ways. And there's examples in the Bible multiple times. You think of the little boy with fish and some bread, feeding a multitude of people. What we perceive as nothing and minute can change a whole lot in a generation. So I leave you with that. There's your small sermonette, if you per se. Let's pop back over here to this. So I'm gonna go out with the old church choir, because I hope through all of this season that the churches get a stirring within their body, within their soul. After we go through all this, whatever it is, this season, that we will wake up and we focus. We got a good reviving spirit inside of us that says, all right, we sat down long enough. We were quiet long enough. I'm just going to share about my Jesus. I'm going to share about my Savior. I'm going to share what God did through Jesus on a cross, no matter what. I'm going to do it with a choir stirring inside. Amen.
Yes.
There's revival and it's spreading like a wildfire in my heart. Sunday morning, hallelujah, and it's lasting all week long. Can you hear it? Can you feel it? It's the rhythm of a gospel song. Won't you choose it? You can lose it. Well, there ain't nothing gonna steal my joy. I've got an old church choir singing in my soul. I've got a sweet salvation and it's beautiful. I've got a heart overflowing cause I've been restored. There ain't nothing gonna steal my joy. No, there ain't nothing gonna steal my joy. In the valleys that I wander, turn to mountains that I can't climb. Oh, you're with me, never leave me. Well, there ain't nothing gonna steal my joy. I've got an old church choir singing in my soul. I've got a sweet salvation and it's beautiful. I've got a heart overflowing cause I've been restored. There ain't nothing gonna steal my joy. No, there ain't nothing gonna steal my joy.
All right, we outside, so we're going to have a little bit of a party for a whole whopping 2.5 seconds. All we want to do is clap our hands and stomp our feet. Here we go.
Hands and stomp your feet till you find that gospel beat, cause it's all you'll ever need. Oh, you'll ever need. Clap your hands and stomp your feet till you find that gospel beat, cause it's all you'll ever need. Oh, you'll ever need. I've got an old church choir singing in my soul. I've got a sweet salvation and it's beautiful. I've got an old church choir singing in my soul. cause I've been restored. There ain't nothing gonna steal my joy. No, there ain't nothing gonna steal my joy. No, there ain't nothing gonna steal my joy.
Amen. Hey, you know, that's what we need to declare, that nothing is going to steal our joy. Even when things get tough, even when we have bad days, and we're all going to have them, but we're going to declare nothing is going to steal my joy. It's been awesome. Thank you guys for having me out again. And Pastor, thank you for the opportunity to, you know, that you trust me.
We'll see you next year.
And we will see you next year. And I'll make sure it's not, I got to make sure it's not the 16th on there, because that's the wife's birthday. But it should move forward. That was last year. Ended up canceling out anyways. But it's been a blessing and an honor to be here with you all again. And thanks so much. And Pastor, I'll turn it over for you for the dismissal.
Well, Josh, it's been fantastic to have you. It's always a joy, as I said. Josh has a talent, and we have all heard it and enjoyed it this morning. Josh, may God bless you and the family, and grant you the grace, joy, peace, and joy that only He can provide. And does anybody have anything they want to add before we close the prayer? If not, let's all bow for prayer. Father, what do we say? We are in the midst of Your creation. We are who and what we are because of who and what You are. We have praised and fellowshipped and worshiped together. We have looked in Your inerrant, immutable Word. And we have asked that God, the Holy Spirit, will enlighten us. You have called us to be salt and light in an ever darkening world. And the world is ever darkening. And sometimes we have difficulty finding our steps. But You have granted us a light unto our paths and a lamp unto our feet. You have commanded us to trust in You with all our hearts and lean not to our own understanding. You have said in all our ways, acknowledge You, and You will make our path straight. For all of this, Father, in the powerful, matchless name of our Lord, our Savior, our Redeemer, Jesus Christ, that He might be honored and glorified. All of us together say,
Amen. Amen.